Morning, guys. Mr. B here. I've got your English for you for Thursday, the 28th of January. Today's lesson is the first part of two lessons. Okay, so we're doing boxing up, which you've done before. All right, so we're going to do half of it today. Okay, and I'm going to model it. I'm going to try and help you lots more. Okay, and the feedback I've been getting is that some of you are really struggling with this English. All right, that's fine. All right, so I'm going to see if I can help you a little bit more today. I do want you to be a bit more independent, though, and I'm going to help you with the first part, okay? But then I'd like you to carry on with the second part. So please stick with it, all right? Little game to start with. I've got something that I'm going to hold up really close to the camera. Can you guess what it is? Ready? Can you guess what it is? No? First person to shout it out if you're in class, or shout it out if you're at home. Okay. If I put it back slightly, can you tell me now what that is now? No. What about now? What about now? Has anyone shouted it out? No? Surely. Oh. Holic. Oh. 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 It's Mr. Hollick's drinks bottle. I'm in Mr. Hollick's class. I hope he doesn't mind me borrowing his drinks bottle for a bit of a game. Who managed to shout it out first? Well done if it was you. Let me share my screen with you. Here we go. Can I ask you to get the date and Walt in today? Okay, so you'll see at the top, Thursday, 28th of January, we're going to start it today. Tomorrow is guided reading, so we won't finish this until Monday, all right? So it's not very much writing today, okay? So for those of you that I know have got a phobia of writing, no need to panic. You've got, so today's lesson at on Thursday, and we'll finish it on Monday, okay? So I've split it up for you. I'm trying to make it as easy as possible for you guys, all right? So please get the Walt in as well, and pause the video when you are ready to start. Okay, you only need to write today's date, and we'll worry about it Monday. Okay, well done for those of you that did yesterday's work on punctuating your speech. Lots of you did a great job on using the four rules correctly, and you put your innovated speech from the three pigs and the wolf, and that conversation that you had, you used excellent said words, all right? Which one did I see that was really, really good? I loved bellowed, someone used that. Oh, where's Ben in my class? I think he used something like hollered, all right? Which means to shout, all right? Which was, I'm gonna give you a special praise, mate. Well done. All right. I really like that one. So well done. Okay. Let's start off with a little brain warm up. Okay. We're still looking at these prefixes today, in and im. All right. What I'd like you to do is choose one of these words. All right. And try them all with in and im in front of it. For example, try this word here, credible. Okay. Now, if I put in front of it, or im, which one makes sense? Is it incredible or incredible? And think about what does that word mean? Something's incredible, it means it's really good, all right? So start having a play around, all right? What about possible? Is it impossible or is it impossible? Okay, and think about the word meanings, all right? There's one correct answer. Okay, you need to choose which one it is. See if you can put it into a sentence. Don't need to write it down. Just see if you can say it and try and make a correct sentence out of it. Okay. All righty. Today, we are moving on again. All right. As I said, I've heavily supported this lesson. So I expect all of you to stick with it. All right. And give it a good go. Our writing target, obviously, as we all know, is to use inverted commas correctly. All right. So I'm going to do all the work, all right? You just need to sit back and listen for the time being. So I want you to think about what happens, okay? I've included it in this slide in a second. So if you're really stuck, you can skip forward. All right. What happens in Babe's Three Little Pigs? Okay. Can we just do a quick summary? If you're in class, stop it and talk about it. Can we remember what happened at the start of it? You all acted out and you drew it right back at the start. Can you remember that first paragraph that starts with "Once upon a time, there's a pig called Babe"? And see if you can remember that first paragraph. Well done if you can. What we're going to do today, or what I'm going to do, is support you by, you've seen this this sketch before. This is obviously our story mountain, all right? And we know that lots of a good story anyway will have this user story mountain, all right? So we'll have an opening, we'll have a build up, then there'll be a problem. It's fixed in, it's in the resolution, and then there's, especially in a fairy tale, a happy ending. Now, it says here in purple, should all these sections be the same? Okay, why or why not? Maybe you want to stop and talk about that. So when you say, when it means the same, think about actually what happens in each of these. Are any of these going to be shorter and longer? Think about this story of Babe's Three Little Pigs. Is there a is there any shorter sections, and is there... There's one section that is really, really long. Can you have a guess? Which section do you think in this story is the longest? All right, and maybe you can think of a reason why. All right, I'm going to come on to that in a second. Okay, so today I'm just going to go to my full screen. I'm going to explain this slide. Now, you can always come back to this slide. Okay, so take note of the time of this. If you need to come back to look, this is the actual story, all right? Then please do. I've done something that is hopefully going to really, really help you. It's a really good visual. So here's the first page, page number two, page number three, and the last bit, page four. All right. Now, I've used a highlighter effect on my board to highlight what I think is the opening, the build-up, the problem, the resolution, and the ending. So in yellow, I think that this is the opening, all right? We're not going to worry about what it is at the moment. I just want you to look at the, when I say the length of each of them. In green, I think that's the build-up. It's not very big. The biggest section is the problem. Now, the problem is all of this, okay? So from there, up there, all of this that's not been highlighted is the problem, all right? In blue, you've got the resolution, and look how short the ending is. Well, the resolution and the ending are actually very, very small in this part. So I'm just going to turn my light back on. Okay. So just have a look at how short they are. Now, the problem is the longest part. Why do we think the problem is the longest part in this story? Just maybe have a chat about that. Okay. The reason the problem is the longest part in the story, well, you've got to think the problem is when the wolf starts chasing the pigs and he goes from house to house. There's a lot of things going on in that problem because, first of all, he needs to go to three pigs' houses. There's a lot of direct speech in all of that because he's saying, little pig, let me in, let me in. So the problem, that is the reason why the problem is the longest, all right? The good news for you today, we're going to worry about the problem on Monday, all right? The only parts today that we're looking at are the opening and the build-up, all right? So that is the only part. Now, as I said, if you're stuck and you don't know, you can't remember how the story goes, all right, you can come back to this page, all right? So, and you can pause it when you get to this page, okay? So I'm going to go forwards. All right, now, I have helped you, I hope, all right? You are not doing this today, this part. I'm just going to show you, to give you some ideas, and then I'll show you the boxing up activity that we're going to be doing, okay? So again, you just need to sit back and listen to this one, all right? So the opening, okay? We're going to start with the opening, and I'm just going to do a summary. A summary means just something that is short. I've used bullet points, okay? So I haven't written in full sentences. I'm just giving an idea of what happened, all right? So I've used this bit in yellow, okay? Just this little bit in yellow. I read it, okay? And what I've done is I've done in bullet points what happened, all right? So I've just made it a little bit smaller. I know that it started with that fairy tale language, once upon a time. Now, I've said that it's, so the first line said, once upon a time, there was a magical pig that could speak, okay? Then I've just highlighted this, the important things there. He had three children, Percy, Pepper and Penny. Okay, he was not able to live on Farm Hoggett's farm. Okay, Mrs. Hoggett, oh yeah, that was it. They were going to eat, she worried that Mrs. Hoggett might eat them. So Babe set them out into the world. Go, my little ones, it's for the world. Okay, just make sure you don't bump into the treacherous wolf. He might be out there somewhere. Okay, so that is just a very brief overview of what happened in this first paragraph. If you want to read it, that would be a really good idea. Okay. Let's go forward. So that was the opening, all right? And on the next page, in a second, I'm going to show you what your task is for today, all right? I've also done it because today we are only looking at the opening and the build-up. So this is the build-up, this part, these bullet points here, all right? So I said, this paragraph starts with, so off they went. And look, I've taken it from the green here. So off they went. The first pig, Percy, was very lazy. He didn't want to work at all. So he built his sty out of straw. Now, I read that and I've summarized it. Look, I said the first pig, Percy, was very lazy. And I've just put straw. Okay, obviously, that doesn't make sense. But when it comes to writing up my story or boxing up my story, all right, I'll be able to come back and I'll go, oh, yeah, I know what that means. Okay, and I've done it for the same. For the next bit, the second pig, Pepper, worked a little harder. He built his house out of sticks. Okay, however, okay, that's a really good word to sentence starter. However, the third pig, Penny, worked hard all day and I put bricks, okay? And it was a sturdy house, complete with a fine fireplace and chimney. So I've just taken the main parts from the opening and the build-up and I've just put them into bullet points to help me. Now, this is going to be your task for today, all right? You would have seen this before. All right, you would have seen these boxing up sheets. Remember, we've got the opening, the build-up, the problem, the resolution, and the ending. Now, as I said to you earlier, we are not going to worry about the problem, the resolution, or the ending today. So you do not need to do that today. All right, we are just looking at the opening and the build-up and making sure that we have got some really good ideas for this. All right, you'll see that the problem is a big box. That's because it is the biggest part of the story. All right. So let's just go back. Oh, by the way, if you do have a printer at home or you do print off the resources, I've attached this boxing up sheet to the class story. So if you go back and you'll be able to print off that page if you want. If you don't, that's absolutely fine. All you need to do is write opening in the margin or next to the margin, and then you can almost create your own little box next to it. Okay. So today, as I said, I've really heavily supported you here. In fact, I've helped you so much that I've done the opening for you, all right? It doesn't mean I don't want you to have a think, though, because it might be that yours could be even better than mine, all right? So what I've done, I'm just going to go back to this page just to make sure that it's really obvious, all right? I've looked at this, and this is what I'd like you to do. I've looked at the opening, okay? All of this in yellow, all right? I've said that this is the opening. I read the opening to remind myself if I wasn't, because I couldn't remember, all right? Then what I've done is I've put it into, it says, what words or phrases could we take to put in there, all right? So I've said, once upon a time, there's a pig called Babe. He was so much, I remember now. He was so much more than a normal pig. He was a magical pig, he could speak. He had three children, okay? This is the bits, the notes I've taken, Percy, Pepper, and Penny, okay? He soon realized that would not be able to live on Farmer Hoggett's farm. Unfortunately, there would not be enough room for them, okay? And he worried that Mrs. Hoggett would want to eat them like she wanted to eat Babe when they had first met, okay? Now, obviously, I haven't written all of that. I've just taken some key phrases that is going to help me, all right, remember when it comes to writing this up, all right? So the bit that I thought was really important, though, was the speech, okay? So I've actually written all of the speech, okay? You might have to write quite small, all right? But all we want to do is get the key phrases, the key ideas. So when they were old enough, Babe sent them into the world. Okay, so what did she say? Go, my little ones, and explore the world. Just make sure you build somewhere safe for yourselves to live, in case the treacherous wolf finds you. He may still be out there somewhere, said Babe. Okay, so I thought that that is the important part of the opening. Now, as I said, if you want to use that, you can just copy that, all right? And that would be a really good start, all right? So if you can pause the video now, if you want to use my ideas, absolutely fine. If you want to think, if you think, oh, I think, oh, this bit's important, okay, read it and do your own, okay? I'd love to see people using their own independent ideas, all right? So that is our opening, all right? So you can pause the video here if you want to just copy my opening and copy some of my ideas, absolutely fine. Okay, that gives you an idea of what we need to do today. All right, guess what we're going to do next? Well, if you've done the opening, okay, I'm going to ask you to do the build-up. Now, I've hopefully made this slightly easier for you. All right, so in the build-up, it talks about how they all built their houses. So it says, so off they went, the first pig, here it is, down here, okay? So I've copied and pasted the actual paragraph that is the build-up, okay? And I've even started off with the first bit of writing for you. So off they went, the first pig. Now, I don't want you to copy all of that into there, okay? I want you to, it's a really good skill to be good at, is to read the writing first and pick out the key points, all right? So read the writing. You might want to say the first pig, lazy, he didn't want to work, straw, okay? And then when it comes to writing it up, you'll be able to put that back into a proper sentence, okay? These just give you the ideas, all right? So what I'd like you to do is once you've done the opening, okay, I'd like you to do the build-up, okay? As I said, I want you to be a bit more independent and do the build-up yourselves. Just pick out the key points, all right? And then stop there, because on Monday, we will have a look at the problem together, all right? So just going to go back over the activity again, what I want you to do. I want you, we're boxing up today. I'd like you to write opening, underline it, and give me a brief summary of what happened in that opening to those first paragraphs, okay, in the opening, all right? Here, I have done that for you if you'd like to copy it. Once you've done the opening, I'd like you underneath to do the build-up, okay? Again, you can use bullet points if you wish, okay, and just read this and pick out the key points that is in the build-up, okay? That is all I want you to do today, and then you can stop, okay? Good luck, and I look forward to seeing some of your ideas.